This is 0.005 pounds of dicamba sprayed last week on the 9th of July. Now, from the wagon, it probably doesn't look like any big deal. And you have to get down in there and see that that newest trifoliate that has come out since that application, it's usually going to take 7 to 10 days before you see it, that you'll see that injury. So on page 41, this is a table from the results we have published. And I have talked about this before, but I'm going to just bring it up one more time to make sure we get these points. By the way, this is 0.005 pounds of dicamba applied last week. This is 0.005 pounds of 2,4-D applied last week at the same time. You can't find any injury there. One take-home message, I guess, soybeans take a lot, are more able to withstand applications of 2,4-D than dicamba. Mm-hmm. So these rates are a little different than what I had done in previous research, but if you look on page 41, just under the soybean yield part of this, we sprayed very, very low rates of 2,4-D and dicamba. We call them driftable fractions. We sprayed all of those on soybeans over several years and several trials and recorded both injury and yield loss. So when we spray, so take home message number one, where's my soybean plant? When we spray this early in the season on soybeans and drift onto them, or tank contamination or volatility or whatever, this does not necessarily translate into yield loss. It did not in our research. Any of our rates of 2,4-D or dicamba that we evaluated did not result in yield loss when they were sprayed at a V3 timing or early in the season. Okay? That's one thing to think about. That's probably not going to be good enough for a farmer who sees his leaves all crinkled up, but I'm just telling you, that's the way it is. Early in the season doesn't mean it's going to be yield loss, all right? However, at the R2 growth stage, we sprayed those same treatments. And as far as dicamba goes, it took us to get to 0.0025 pounds of dicamba before we caused a 9-bushel yield loss. Everybody see that? It's 56 bushels there. So 0.08 ounces to the acre of dicamba caused a 9-bushel yield loss when it was sprayed at the R2. So all of you are probably saying, what in the world does all that mean? I finally tried to put this into better terms. I figured out last night, if we had a John Deere 49, whatever those things are, with 1,200 gallon tank, 90 foot booms, if you put this much clarity, or had this much clarity, this is clarity by the way, this is dicamba, if you had this much dicamba in 1,200 gallons, that equates to 0.0025 and a 9-bushel yield loss, okay? I don't know if you're impressed by that or could care less, or that's too much or too little, or I don't know what that means to you. But, so this is what caused yield loss. What caused injury and what caused cupping? Every rate that we sprayed caused injury and caused cupping, okay? Visual, 0.000025, okay? Every rate that we sprayed, and that is what that looks like in 1,200 gallons. You need that much dicamba in 1,200 gallons to get cupping on some other person's soybeans. So what does all that mean to you?
Sometimes it's not a big deal to see cupping.
Sometimes it's not a big deal to see cupping. Make sure you clean out your tanks whenever this technology comes onto the market.